Refugees and people smugglers are never far from the headlines in Australia at the moment. But a chance conversation with SBS's Les Murray brought home a very different perspective on the issue. Les has a soft spot for people smugglers. They risk their lives to deliver his family to freedom. Whether smugglers are mercenaries or angels, most refugees can't flee from danger across borders without their help. For Les, it's been the biggest regret of his life that he's never had the chance to once again meet the smugglers who saved his family. So, a few weeks back, we returned to track them down. Or 55 years later, if they're now dead, to find their names, their stories, and to thank their families. Les Murray is on familiar ground. But his mission to Hungary has nothing to do with football. For once, his mind is not on the game. So what makes you want to do this journey now, Les? What sort of triggered this journey?
Well, in Australia these days, there's a lot of talk about people smugglers, and they're pretty well demonised. And it occurred to me that the people smuggler that I knew was actually a pretty good guy. So I'm here to find him, not to arrest him or even admonish him, but to thank him.
Les has set himself a near impossible task, 55 years later, to find a chain of paid smugglers who rescued his family. And he only has one name, Julius, or Jula.
It was a network of people who helped us. It was a part of a broad conspiracy. They took enormous risks to do what they did. And I believe it's my duty, not just a wish, to thank them. Driving back to Budakeshi for the first time on this journey, I was quite nervous because my greatest fear was that no revelations would emerge. That's it there. See those houses with the red roofs, with the tiled roofs? That's it. That was the greatest fear when I set out on this entire journey. Okay. Now, can we get an angle bit back? First floor. So my mum would come out there and start yelling, "Time for dinner," and we all have to drop our football game and go inside. We went inside to do our homework.
First football plot for you, huh?
Yep. It was. It's quite emotional, you know.
I bet.
Amazing.
Les Murray was born Laszlo Uga, the middle of three boys, and grew up happily at this apartment until Russian tanks crushed the Hungarian uprising of 1956, forcing the family to flee. Today he's hoping to find someone who lived here in 56 who may know who helped them escape. But he's not having much luck finding any names he remembers. Starting with his own childhood apartment, Les begins the first of a series of cold door knocks, chipping away at a 55-year-old mystery.
Well, when I was walking up the stairs, I was, the old ticker was pounding seriously about knocking on the door and finding maybe the residents who took over from us here.
This is it?
This is the door. Let me see the sign on it. Shall I knock?
I think you should knock. You've come so far, Liz. You've got
just ring.
There's no ring, no bell. There's nobody home, I suspect.
The owners of his apartment are away, but there are a lot more doors to go.
Kezi Choklov, én nevem Ürge László. Ausztráliából jöttem.
In particular, Les is hoping to find the Keresztes family. The Keresteses planned the escape with Les's parents, and together they all fled for the border. At the last step, they were captured by the Russians. Les has never known what happened to them.
Keresztes.
Igen, azokra emlékszem.
Igen?
Persze.
És azok itt vannak még?
Nem, vagy? Meghaltak.
Meghaltak, mind a kettő.
Igen.
Szóval a gyerekek nincsenek a közelben
nem,
valahol.
Nincs.
Ön nem tudja, hogy hol
nem,
vannak.
Nem, sajnos nem.
Értem. Jó, még egyszer köszönöm szépen.
Kérem szépen.
Csókolom. Well, when the revolution broke out on October 23, all our hopes rose. The revolution was crushed and all the hopes were extinguished. Some of them were defiant, like my father. You know, he opened his big mouth a few times and other people, but the general population was very, very intimidated.
The uprising against the communists, which Les's father supported, was brutally crushed by the Russians. And then the hunt was on for those who joined the rebellion, causing tens of thousands to rush for the border, and the people smugglers were in business.
Tehát ön 56-ban itt volt?
Ó, már rég, persze. Igazából mi is akartunk menni, akkor amikor akartunk menni, már késő volt. Azt kérte az illető, hogy 100 doboz cigarettát, ha hozok, akkor elvisz minket.
Aki átvitte volna, igen.
És elhoztam...
She was here in 56. But she doesn't
elhoztam
remember.
A cigarettát, elutaztam, pedig az is azt ilyes volt már vonattal menni, és elhoztam, és akkor már nem vállalta.
Like others here, this lady knew the Keresteses, but never knew they'd tried to defect.
Megsikerült
átszer. Én ezt nem is tudtam sose, hogy ők akartak.
Erről nem beszéltek?
Nem. Ők most a fia...
There were secrets kept very, very tightly. Nobody who was involved in such conspiracies as helping defectors ever spoke about them again because they were fearful of retributions. Nevem Ürge László.
Ürge
László. Én 11 éves gyerek voltam, itt laktam a D blokkban. Tehát ön emlékszik?
Igen.
Emlékszik rá?
Igen. Hát kisrác volt.
Igen.
Ebben a házban.
Leülhetek? Leülhetek? She remembers the family.
Oh, you're kidding.
Igen, és a szülők azok, és akkor elköltöztek maguk. Biró nénivel cseréltek, nem? Vagy kivel?
Nem. Elmondom a sztorit. Mi diszidált?
Diszidált. És hol laknak?
Ausztráliában, Sydneyben.
Jézus Mária.
És oda mentünk.
A világ végére. Valamit szeretni kell ebbe a
korba. Mire emlékszik? Abban a szempontból, hogy mi történt, mikor az Ürge család eltűnt. Egyszerűen reggel 3-kor egy teherautó itt várt, és elvitt minket le a határra. Eltűntünk. Erre emlékszik?
Hát én arra nem emlékszek, csak az, hogy elmentek, de hogy hova vagy mi, aztán később beszélgették, hogy diszidáltak.
The old people are great. I mean, you can always rely on them. They remember everything. If we didn't have them, we wouldn't have found anything. Na most a keresztesekről akarok valamit kérdezni. She also remembered the Keresztes family very well, and I was very, very keen to find out what happened to them. Velünk együtt mentek a határra, együtt tervezték ki az egész utat. És az történt, hogy... A keresztes?
Hát az én uramnak a legjobb barátja volt a bandi.
Most azt kérdezem én öntől, Lakatos néni, hogy velük mi történt? She knew the Kerestes family, and she told us what happened to them, that the parents had both died, and the son, who was then 4 years old when they attempted to escape, was now living on the Balaton district, which is a resort area.
Great memory.
És akkor... Most ezeknek a Balatonon van nagy vendéglőjük.
Vendéglőjük, igen. And was running a restaurant with the name Kerestes as the name of the restaurant. So that gave us our first lead, really. Jó napot kívánok! A három személy első osztály Balaton-Almádira, oda-vissza. I had a feeling all along that the Kerestes family would be quite bitter about what happened. I didn't know what to expect from him, whether he would embrace me and welcome me, or whether basically told me to go away because of what happened to them. I was tense. Andor, te vagy?
Igen, szervusz.
Szervusz.
Gyere, öle. Andor.
Ölej meg. Szervusz. Olyan kicsi voltál. Ugye? Én meg ekkora. Hát körülbelül.
11 éves voltál?
11.
Nem szervusz.
Valamit változtál, de nem olyan sokat. Egy kis idő óta nem láttalak.
Megfejérettünk.
77.
Ti szeresek vagytok?
Ausztrália, inkább boros vagyok, de ilyen időben jó a hideg sör. Ez a három.
Olyan boromba, hogy két nyelven beszél, ajaj.
Ez a három srác, emlékszel?
Les learns more in these few hours than he's learnt in 55 years.
Értem.
That one of the smugglers, who he knew only as the one-legged man, was a distant relative of Andor's.
Na, igen. Igen, ez egy sárs, bicegő ember volt.
Another relative owned one of the houses they were hidden in along the way.
Értékes, amit mondtál, mert én soha nem tudtam, hogy ki finanszírozta az egészet.
And surprisingly, he learns who bankrolled the most crucial part of the operation, the final people smugglers who need to be paid in hard cash.
Pletyka, nem pletyka, anyámnak az elmondása alapján, hogy megkapták a pénzt. Mondott az anyám, hogy általában mi finanszíroztuk jobban ezt az utat, és mi maradtunk kint, és nektek sikerült kimenni.
Ez lehet, hogy így is volt.
Lehet?
Tanúja voltam, hogy engem küldött a te édesanyádhoz az én anyám kölcsönkérni pénzt. Ez többször megtörtént.
Akkor ez igaz, lehet,
tehát
hogy anyám mondott?
Ez igaz, nem, ez igaz volt.
Hogy mi
finanszíroztuk? And then the savage irony that they're the ones who get arrested. They're the ones who get stuck. They're the ones who... I turned back, never to attempt such a thing again.
És apám meg fair play volt, hogy akkor induljatok ti előbb el, mert hogy sokan vagytok, nekünk talán két gyerek könnyebb, ti, hogy öten voltatok.
Andor's memories of the people smugglers they engaged aren't as fond as Les's.
Ja. Nem, hát egy összeg belőle oda lett nekik adva a pénz, igen. Aztán utána ja. Keveselhették a pénzt, ja. És azt mondták, hogy na még akartak kérni, és akkor már nem volt, és akkor bennünket meg már visszadobtak.
Ja.
Details aside, Les has more personal business to conclude. His parents never contacted the Kereszteses again, doubly bitter now, given how much he knows they contributed.
Nem keres, ez valahol fájdalmas, kicsit sérelmezték. Nagyon-nagyon Ausztráliába készültetek, tehát készültek faterékba is, az anyámba is, hogy Ausztrália. Hogy na, talán már biztos sikerült nekik, és kint élnek Ausztráliába, ennyit mondtak.
De nem hallottatok semmit, ez csak sejtettétek. Szerintem restelte. Szerintem nem tudta azt, hogy kell összeköttetésbe lépni egy ilyen jó barátjával, ezt nem tudta szerintem leírni.
Hát ugye aztán ment tovább az élet. Fater biztos sajnálta, sajnálta, hogy elvesztette a barátját. Ez biztos, hát ez meg tudom.
Yeah. My parents didn't contact them because they were too embarrassed to. They wouldn't have known what to say to them. And that embarrassment remained with me. about that, and I had to put that right.
Én csak az anyám néha síralmában, amikor mondta, hogy az Isten, hogy sajnálta, hogy hát végül is nem sikerült nekünk kimenni. Azt mondja, most már ott farmerok lehetnénk, mert mindig a földet akarták túrni, vagy hogy nagy, nem tudom, aztán nektek hogy sikerült?
Nekünk, hát nekünk, nem volt az se paradicsom.
Egészséget.
Neked is. Köszönöm szépen, Andor.
Bye bye, see you.
Szervusz, Andor. Ciao.
Amazing.
Amazing?
Yeah, amazing, amazing. Amazing experience. Wow.
Armed with a few leads from Andor, Les starts his search for the traffickers with historian Dr. Janos Reiner at the 1956 Institute.
It's a blown-up tank.
Reiner specialises in maintaining the records of the Hungarian uprising and researching the stories of those involved, including those who dashed to the border when the revolution was crushed.
Going through the frontier without permission was a very serious crime.
Reiner can fill Les in on the smuggling trade, the risks.
It was about 5 years imprisonment.
The payments that smugglers received.
It was about 1,000 and 1,500.
The type of people that did it.
Knew the places, knew the woods, knew the...
Anything but the names of any people smugglers from that time.
It's a great pity.
Les is on his own. In the chaotic first week of December, Les's family and the Keresztes family left Budapest on a two-day train journey to get closer to the border. But their chances of success didn't seem high. Hundreds were being turned back on the trains.
And the people on the other train who were heading back to Budapest were screaming at us, yelling out, saying, "Forget about it, don't go back, turn around. It's hopeless, they've closed the borders."
As they approached the town of Kermend, the police stopped the train, dragged off Les's family, beating his father, and marching them off to a nearby army base.
That could be it. That could be the building.
See that grey building there? That rather drab grey building?
Yeah.
Les's father had an elaborate alibi, presenting this official letter, stating that his children were sick and were going to recuperate for the winter in Kermend, at the large warm house of the Durrani family. In 1956, it seems, the name Durrani was powerful enough to override the suspicions of police, but now no one has heard of them. The search for their house in Kermend is proving fruitless. But the old man sitting behind our fixer Tibor can't help but overhear.
Köszönöm szépen, viszont hallásra. She told me that there is no Durrani in the files.
Durrani last novel.
Incredibly, Les's luck is in. He knew the Durranis.
Durrani László.
Durrani. Az meg ügyvéd volt ott az evangélikus paplakása szemben, a tökön. Meg ott laktam mellettük, a Zsuzsa, a hogomnak, a piroskának, a komjáti piroskának volt a barátnője. Ez a hely. Akkor elmegyek, bárcsak, megmutatom, hol van az ép. És a Zsuzsa volt itt legtovább.
When Les last passed through these streets, the final battles of the uprising were still being fought.
By then the revolution, don't forget, had already been crushed. But there were still pockets of people who were still fighting or resisting it.
And the Durranis, a solidly middle-class family, were sheltering not just refugees, but fighters as well on the night that Les hid there.
This is the house. Two young freedom fighters walked in, and my father said to this boy, who was, you know, had a machine gun, he had a sash of bullets. My father said to him, "Why don't you come with us? Come with us and find your freedom." And he said, "Well, we'd like to, but we've got some unfinished business here."
Mrs. Durrani, who Les remembers best, was old then and now long dead. and probably took her heroic story to the grave. But Les takes comfort from hearing from her neighbour that the authorities never learnt of her role.
The conversation with the old lady next door to the Juranya house was important because it gave me comfort as to what happened to the Juranya family, and that there was no retribution. They were never caught. Nobody ever knew that they were helping refugees. So it was it gave me a lot of comfort.
After a night in hiding, Les and the Uyghur family left the Durrani house on a horse and cart with an old farming lady who was probably part of the paid network. They drove to Pinkmensent on the border dressed as farmers with a story about attending a local wedding that got them past the Russian roadblock.
Okay, we're coming into Pinkmensent, so about here was the checkpoint.
The lady with the horse and cart delivered them to the house of a young man named Julius.
I'm pretty sure, yeah, that's that first house. This is our street.
With just two streets in the village of Pinkmensent, Les is confident he'll remember it, and he hopes Julius will be there, now probably around 80.
Slow down. This is the house. This is the house. This one on your left now. 94.
That's it?
That's the house. I just want to peer over this gate. By this point, I was starting to get seriously pensive because this was the moment approaching where I would knock on Julius's door. Yeah.
So, we're going to do the door knock and see.
I guess that's all we can do.
Okay.
See what happens. And find out whether he was still there or not, but more importantly, whether he was dead or alive. Nice, cute little dogs. Bocsánatot kérek. Gyula nevű urat keresek. Gyula.
Mi úgy kerültünk ide, mi ezt nem tudjuk.
Nem is tudjuk azt.
Kérlek, attól kéne megkérdezni az idősektől.
A Ilona néni. Az Ilona néni látod, a mindent tud.
Jó, közelben van?
Ó, várj!
Én ezen a felén lakuk, meg azon a felén.
Jó.
Azt tudja,
akkor menjünk. Segíthetek? Azért, mert üres. Egy kis paprika van benne.
Igen, azt kap.
Csókolom, viszlát.
Meg szeretné kicsit lenni.
Ja.
Ugye jó, csendes. Ugye meghalt.
Igen.
Most 9 éve.
Uh-huh.
Hát aztán el vagyok egyedül.
Igen.
Gyerekek, gyűnek.
Igen. És ki, az, ön meg az ura, aki...
Vendégeket
hoztam,
ne haragudjon.
Ne, anya, haragudjon.
Spjanak
le.
Itt a
konyhában. Itt a konyhában?
Igen.
Okay. Köszépen. Köszépen. Igen. So we talked to this old lady who's been in the village a long time.
Ja, meg Orbáné. Hát, az Orbán családban volt Gyula. De hogy ő...
Engem az érdekel, főleg, hogy mi lett ezzel a Gyulával, éle még, yes, she says, it must be the Orbáns. They lived in that house, and Orbán was their surname.
Ő nem volt itthon.
Where is Julius? She didn't know.
Hát az Anna, ahol kellene, már...
But she said, why don't you go to the house next door? Ki ez az Anna? Because a member of the family, Julius' sister-in-law, still lives there by herself. Jó, hát akkor meglátogatjuk az Anna nénit.
Hát az kül, hogyha
beenged.
Ha beenged, ugye ki tudja, ha egyedül valamegy.
de csak az én kísérletemben már nem engedi be őket.
Jó, jó. Akkor bemehetünk? Bár. Megpróbáljuk?
Akkor a kutya van.
Kezit csókolom, köszönöm szépen. Igen, hálás vagyok.
Viszlát!
Thank you very much. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Anna néni! Anna néni!
So the lady says, oh, she's too scared. She's in there. I know she's in there. But she's scared. She won't respond.
Nem csak valakit keresünk az Orbán családból. Mert mi, én itt 11 éves fiú koromban itt voltam ebben a házban, és az Orbán család minket átsegített a határon. És én meg akarom nekik köszönni.
Miért, de megköszönhet, nem él, már meghalt.
A Gyula?
Van Gyula.
Gyula meghalt? Mikor?
A fia él még, Peresnyén.
He died, Julius, 3 years ago.
3 years ago?
He was 81.
Ah, Liz, sorry.
Az az egy fia van.
Kocsmáros, az egy fia.
The best we can do is visit his grave.
And let's see if we can find his son at least. You can
yes.
Speak to his son, huh?
Yes. Yes. Okay. I think that's what we should do.
Julius seemed very honest and sincere. He was a typical country boy, and I know he was decent in the way he stopped his father from taking my mother's coat as part payment, and simply the way he took care of us. When he led us on the walk to the border, he held my hand and my little brother Joe's hand. He was the ultimate professional when it came to helping us through this danger. Julius, Orbán Gyula.
If you'd had a chance to speak to him, what would you have said?
I would have said thank you. And that is all. And then I would have had a beer with him maybe and talk about the times, 56, the adventures, the risks, and about his life since then.
Les doesn't get his beer with Julius, but he gets one with his grandson, Belez.
Kocsantjunk egyet erre, ha megengeded. Szervusz, egészség, az emlékére, nagypapád emlékére. Yeah, it's him.
It's him?
That's him, all right. That's it, him.
Julius had never uttered a word about what he'd done.
Büszke vagyok rá.
Igen.
Vagy talán nem akarta azt, hogy na most azt mondjak, na ez az ember ezt tette, meg azt tette, mármint pozitív értelemben.
Igen. Lehet, hogy nem akart hencegni.
Nem akart hencegni. Soha nem volt olyan.
Les tells Belez how his grandfather hid the Uyghur family from soldiers who were searching for them after the Kereshteshes were arrested.
But what happened after the old lady managed so successfully to negotiate the checkpoint with the Russian soldiers, she got cocky and went back and picked them up the same day.
To come to the same wedding, presumably.
To come to the same wedding, and she told the same story to the soldiers with the Kereshtesh family. The soldiers got suspicious and arrested them. So then Julius hid us in the hay shed at the back of the yard. So this is all firewood, but if you can imagine a floor being across those beams, and that's where Julius told us to hide. And we literally buried ourselves in hay so that if the soldiers or the police come in here, they couldn't find us anywhere.
Yeah.
And this is because you'd seen the Russians capture the Kereshteshes and the old lady.
I'm sure they would have put the squeeze on her. Where is the other family?
Yeah.
Where is the other family that you took,
yeah.
that you brought here? I don't know what happened. That's a mystery, actually.
Maybe she didn't do you in. You might owe her a big favour too.
Yep.
She might have stuck to her guns.
She may have.
Not told them where you were.
In which case, she would have been. She would have faced consequences.
At midnight, the family made their dash for the border.
So from my memory, we left the house, crossed the road diagonally, and then turned into these wild fields across this bridge. So within a short while, we bashed our way through the scrub and came into an open, clear field, and which was covered in light snow. And as we emerged, we could see the towers in the distance, both sides, roughly a couple of hundred meters to either side of us, and we could hear shooting. And Julius was holding my hand, saying, "Keep calm, they're only shooting in the air." It was scary, but the immense power of this man, Julius, is remarkable as I think back, because we were so confident in him. He was so calming. At this point, we stopped, and Julius said, "We have to stop here and say goodbye, because this is now the border. Beyond over there is Austria, and this is as far as I can go." He wished us luck. He hugged us all. He kissed the three boys and turned around, and we all turned around to look at him, walk back and disappear into the darkness. Julius told us earlier that we should just continue walking in the same direction, and within a short time we will come across an Austrian village. Suddenly we were on our own, with our future a total mystery.
Laszlo Uerga leaving Hungary. Les has written a blog for our website with more about his story and how we came to make that journey. That's at sbs.com.au/dateline.